2021 started off with a bang when Trump supporters stormed the US Capitol, seeking to overturn his defeat in the presidential election. A week after the riot, Trump was impeached for incitement of insurrection. Only weeks later, Joe Biden was inaugurated without any problems, making him the 46th president of the United States. Later in January, Grace Tame was named Australian of the Year. The sexual assault survivor and advocate gave this powerful speech, setting the tone for the year ahead.
Well, hear me now. Using my voice amongst a growing chorus of voices that will not be silenced. Let's make some noise, Australia!
In the beginning of February, Myanmar's military seized power in a coup against the democratically elected government, detaining political leaders in early morning raids. The coup led to mass protests, where hundreds were killed by military and police forces. In mid-February, former parliamentary staffer Brittany Higgins shared publicly the story of her alleged sexual assault in Parliament House. The case and how it was handled led to a women's march in Canberra and a review of Parliament workplace culture that found one in three people working in Parliament had experienced some kind of sexual harassment. In March, a historical rape allegation against Attorney General Christian Porter becomes public. Porter denied the claim and launched a defamation case against the ABC. The case was later dropped, with the ABC agreeing to pay all of Porter's mediation costs. Later in the month, a huge container ship ran aground in the Suez Canal. Hundreds of ships were left waiting at either end of the canal until a fleet of tugboats finally got it free and unblocked the passage. In April, former Minneapolis police officer Derek Chauvin was convicted of murdering George Floyd. In May, the world watched on as countless missiles were sent back and forth between Gaza and across Israel in one of the deadliest episodes of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict seen in years. 11 days of fighting left 12 Israelis and 232 Palestinians dead. In June, Greater Sydney and parts of New South Wales went into a COVID-19 lockdown after an outbreak of the Delta variant in Bondi. Cases spread across the country, leading to every state and territory imposing restrictions again. Hundreds of people died with COVID-19 in this outbreak. On the 15th of August, the Taliban captured Kabul after 20 years of war in Afghanistan. The Afghan president fled the country and was followed days later by the US, Australian and allied troops. Australia scrambled to evacuate its citizens as thousands rushed to Kabul's airport to escape the Taliban takeover. At the end of September, Gladys Berejiklian resigned as New South Wales Premier after the state's anti-corruption watchdog announced they would investigate her over her relationship with an ex-MP. Dominic Perrottet becomes the state's new Premier. In mid-October, New South Wales celebrated the end of their 106-day lockdown. Weeks later, Melbourne exited its sixth lockdown after 70% of people over 16 in Victoria received two doses of the COVID-19 vaccine. In November, the World Health Organization named a new COVID-19 variant of concern, Omicron. The variant was discovered by scientists in South Africa, but has since spread rapidly around the world due to its high transmissibility. In December, Queensland and Tasmania reopened their borders to vaccinated travellers. Families long separated were reunited just in time for Christmas. WA announced they would finally reopen their border too, but not until February next year.